if y'all would give Miss Hannah a warm welcome. She's going to be giving the devo this morning.
My. Awesome. How are we doing this morning? Wow. It's like a little small group. How lovely. Let me just get set up here for a second. All right, well, good morning, LifePoint family. You all look so lovely here, bright and early on this Thursday morning. If you don't know who I am, my name is Hannah. If you've probably seen me, I serve anywhere that's needed. You might see me running booth, stage, our mini duck farm in the back. But I truly am so honored to be here, and I'm so thankful to Pastor Danny and Pastor Rachel for letting me speak on something that is near and dear to my heart, something that God has cultivated in this church in an incredibly intentional and actually truly beautiful way, and that is our young adults and our LP Academy students. So our young adults started around this time last year, and we have grown far more than we thought that we ever would, which is absolutely, like, just God moving completely in this community. People have found their community through our young adults. We see them serving all around LifePoint, and it's truly amazing. And my favorite people ever are our students, too. And particularly our LPA students join our summer internship. So LPA is LP Academy. They join our summer internship, so that's basically just them learning about how we run LifePoint and how they are crucial parts of the body of this church. And we are so excited for this year's LP Academy, for this summer to feature, to further their knowledge and involvement, as well as add some new students to this core. So the verse that I will be speaking on, if you have your Bibles, will be in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, and it reads, "But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possession, that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light." Now, after reading this verse and kind of dissecting its contents, there were a few phrases that stood out to me. And the first one that I'd like to spend some time on is a royal priesthood. So during this time, royalty and priesthood were completely separable. It was easy to make them two things that were utterly individual. Priests and royalty rarely saw eye to eye. So because of this, that is used in this phrase together, in agreement, it emphasizes the complete cultural shift that Jesus is calling upon his generation to cultivate. That his way is out of the ordinary. That it is practically in complete opposition of what the world is calling us to be. And Peter follows this phrase with another phrase that reads, "a holy nation." The word holy is to be God. God is holy, untouched, pure in every way, sacred. So this first half of the verse is explaining the value of this calling. We are called as a generation to be set apart from this world, purposefully dissimilar, while also striving to be like God and to share his love and wonder in any and every way that we can, which is precisely what the second part of this verse is directing us to do. To proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. If I were walking in death, not The Walking Dead, the show that y'all give yourselves nightmares over, but walking in death, in darkness, in sin, and Jesus Christ saved my literal life, and took me out of that darkness and into his marvelous light. Other translations might say wonderful or excellent light. I would be shouting them on the mountaintops, right? Or at least I probably should. That is what Jesus is calling this generation to do. To be separated from this world so that we may share his marvelous light and save others from the darkness that this world so generously provides. And I know that I mentioned that this talk was geared towards young adults and this generation, and LPA students, and students and young adults are the generation that is currently under the microscope in our society. We're the ones that are being our next scientists, teachers, politicians. However, this verse is geared towards all generations. Otherwise, it probably would have said just Gen Z. It didn't say that. All races, cultures, families, and churches. We are all meant to help cultivate this culture, and I'm genuinely so excited to see this garden of life that and love that is being tended to right before our eyes. Seth, one of our students, just spoke last Monday, or this Monday, about what God is doing in our kids and student ministry, and he's excited. The band right behind me that just played consists of young adults who are using God's gifts that were given to them to reach the lives of new believers. They are literally ushering in what God is calling us to do, and they're excited. So as I'm ending, I just ask that you would join this movement, join the calling that Jesus has given to each and every one of us. I promise you there is no circumstance that you hold that God can't use. So during this time of prayer that we're about to go into, I encourage you to gear your prayers towards where God might be calling you to go. Maybe it's specific, like a person at work that maybe God's kind of tugging on your heart to like have a conversation with, or maybe it's something that feels almost like a whisper that you can't quite get clarity on, but that's something that needs to have prayer over. I know that was, for me, a big thing. It was like he was whispering at me, but I wasn't really quite listening enough because it was a whisper, and so I needed to quiet the parts of my life that were too loud. And so that's something that I just want you to look on. And regardless, God is excited for what he's going to be doing in your life. So I just encourage you during this time of prayer that you would do that. But before we do, I'm just going to pray over us together. If you would bow your heads with me. Father God, I thank you so, so, so much for this beautiful day that you have given us. You have called this day your own, and all of us in it have a calling and a purpose for today, for tomorrow, and for years to come, Father God. I pray over every single soul in this room today that you will bless them in everything that they do, in their finances, their families, themselves, Father God, that you would just have your hand of protection over them forever, Father God, and that over these prayers that you would just have your hand over every word that was written on these cards and every word that is spoken in this room today, that you would just be present here in this place. I thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak, and that if anything was not of you, that it would fall straight to the floor, Father God, that you would only use your goodness to work into the lives of every single person here today. I love you and I praise you. And in Jesus' name we say, amen. All right. Thank you guys so, so much for being with us. We're going to go into a time of individual